Okay, so in today's lesson, we're going to be doing a bit of a differentiation, okay? So we move on to the next page. First of all, we're going to differentiate with respect to x, okay? So the first question basically is asking me what happens when y equals 2x cubed minus 7. Now, when you differentiate, what you got to remember is you bring the power to the front. Ends up to be 3 multiplied by 2, and then you take 1 away from the power, so it used to be 3, now it becomes a 2. And the answer to this will be 6x squared. The 7 itself disappears because all numbers, when differentiated, disappear. Okay, now on to the second question, right? And the second question is similar to the first, y equals 6 minus 5x squared. We differentiate this, the 6 will disappear. So that's dy dx, the 6 will disappear. You bring the 2 to the front, so it's going to be minus 2 times 5. Take 1 away from the power, which is x, and the answer there will be minus 10x. Okay. The next one I'm doing involves the product rule, okay? Now, to identify a product rule question, you'll notice that there will be two distinct numbers that are multiplied by each other. Using the product rule, you call the first one u and the second one v. Okay? So, what you can do is you can just write down your values u equals x minus 4. This means that the u dx must be 1. Differentiate 1x, it becomes 1. Differentiate 4, it disappears. V equals x plus 3. Differentiate v, and you get, once again, you get 1. Now, when we differentiate the entire thing, we go through the following procedure. So, dy dx ends up to be equal to u times the v dx, so which is x minus 4 in a bracket times 1 plus v times the u dx, which is x plus 3 multiplied by the u dx, which is also 1. And then finally, we're going to have x minus 4 plus x plus 3. Add them together, and we get 2x minus 1. And that is the answer for dy dx. Okay, B part 1 involves the chain rule, and the chain rule is basically, as we can see in the corner, you bring the power to the front, so 4 ends up in front of the 3x minus 4. You take 1 away from the power, hence the 4, power 4 turns into the power 3. Then what you have to remember to do is differentiate the brackets. When you differentiate 3x minus 4, you get 3, hence the extra 3 at the end. Now with this in mind, we're going to try this one now here, where y equals 7x minus 3 to the power of 5. First step, bring the 5 to the front and take 1 away from the power. So the 5 goes to the front. We take 1 away from the power. And then we have to differentiate what's inside the bracket itself. When you differentiate 7x minus 3, you get 7. Key thing to remember when wrapping up these questions is you're never, ever, ever allowed multiplying by the chain, multiplying by the bracket that has the power. So we simply multiply the 7 by the 5, and the answer here will be 35 bracket 7x minus 3 to the power of 4. For B part 2, we have the quotient rule, right? To identify a quotient rules always have one number with an x in it divided by another number with x. Usually that's the way it goes. So we can see here that this is u, and this one here is v. Okay, so once again, we're just going to write out quickly, u is 2x. If we're to differentiate 2x, that's what's called du dx, and that equals 2. And if we were to write down v, v is x minus 1. And if we're to differentiate v, we get dv dx, and dv dx would therefore be 1, With this in mind, we're going now going to do out the formula, okay? So start off with dy dx is what we're asked to get. So dy dx ends up to be v times du dx. So v is x minus 1 in a bracket. Okay, that doesn't look much like a 1, so we'll just go back here for a second. Make sure it's nice and clear. X minus 1 in one bracket. Then du dx, which is 2 in the second bracket. Then we're going to get minus u, which is minus 2x. And then we're going to get the v dx, which is x minus 1. We now need to get phi squared on the bottom. Phi squared, which is x minus 1 squared. Okay. What we do next is the following. We're going to tidy this up. So what we're going to do is we're going to multiply out these numbers here. So x by 2, we get is 2x, minus 1 by 2, minus 2. Okay, here's a tricky one here. So what we're going to do is we're going to take away the bracket here, more or less. So it's going to be minus 2x, okay? So let's say minus 2x into x minus 1. Okay, so what we're going to do here is minus 2x squared. And then that's going to be plus 2x. Okay, and this is all going to be over. Now, just spot a quick mistake here, okay? And the mistake I made was basically, I didn't put down dv dx. Dv dx was wrong here, okay? So, I actually knew there was a mistake because none of these really cancelled each other out, which is normally what happens with these types of questions, okay? So, just go back to this part here, right? It's u times dv dx, okay? And dv dx was actually 1. As opposed to x minus 1. So you always got to be very careful when inputting your proper numbers, okay? So we're going to multiply this out again, and we get 2x minus 2 minus 2x. Now they cancel, okay? Into x minus 1 squared. And the answer, therefore, is going to be minus 2 over x minus 1 squared. Okay. Okay. The next question is quite an interesting one, okay? So what we got to do is we got to find out basically the height of the balloon after 2 seconds, okay? So to find the height of the balloon after 2 seconds, it basically means t equals 2, find h. Now the only formula relating h and t together is this one here, right? So h would end up to be, this for part 1, part I, would be 120 multiplied by 2, minus 15 times 2 squared. Okay. And once you just put that into your calculator, you're going to get 240 minus 60, which is going to be 180. Now, it says h is a meter, so it's going to be 180 meters. Okay. For part 2, we're looking at the speed. The minute you see speed in a differentiation question, distance is the equation. When you differentiate the distance equation, you get speed. So v is actually dh dt when you differentiate the h formula with respect to t. So when you differentiate this, 120t changes into 120. Bring the 2 to the front, and it'll come minus 30t. Okay? And what we do know about this is we want t to be 1 second. So therefore, the speed of the ball, as expected, when it's flying up in the air, it's going to lose pace. It was 120. Now it's 120 minus 30 times 1, which means it's 90. Now also remember your units. The unit for velocity is meters per second to the minus 1. Okay. Part 3. After how many seconds is the balloon momentarily at rest? It's momentarily at rest when its velocity equals 0. Therefore, we're looking for 120 minus 30t equals to 0. Bring the 30t over one side, so we end up getting 120 equals 30t, which is the same thing as 30t being equal to 120. Once this happens, t equals 120 over 30, and t will equal 4. Okay. Next part, okay? the next part is find the maximum height reached by the balloon. Now, the maximum height reached by the balloon is when its velocity is zero. Okay. So the balloon comes up, and more likely comes back down. Okay. So the time it takes 4 seconds for the balloon to come to rest, which means it's more than likely the balloon's maximum height. It comes up here, and after t equals 4 seconds, more likely it's on its way back down. Okay, so we're going to do is we're going to get the H formula, and the H formula is 120t minus 50t squared. 120t, not minus 50t, as it is minus 15t squared. And then what we're going to do is we're going to put in t equals 4, which is 4 seconds. So what height is the balloon after 4 seconds? Okay. Then times 4 squared. Now, you're going to have to put this straight into your calculator to figure out. Okay, so we'll just quickly put this into the calculator, and you'll end up with 240 meters. So its maximum height it's going to rise today is 240 meters. Okay, and that concludes that question. Now, next question, we're going to be differentiating with respect to x again. Quite similar to the first question, okay? But this time we're going to be, it's actually very similar, okay? So what we're going to do here is we're going to do dy dx, okay? So dy dx turns out to be, this will change into 2x minus 3. Remember, 2 goes in front, take 1 away from the power. This one here, you just get rid of the x, 2x minus 3. Now the next part is y equals 1 over x squared. Now for this question here, what I'm going to do is I'm going to propose that we use the quotient rule, okay? There is other ways of doing it, but I don't like to complicate methods, okay? So u and v, okay? So we'll just go into the corner here as we always do. U is 1. If u is 1, when you differentiate 1, you get the u, when you differentiate u, you get the u dx, and the u dx will be 0, okay? V is x squared. Differentiate x squared to get the v dx, and what you'll get is 2x, okay? Now, also what we got to do here is basically start plugging it into the formula here, okay? So we got dy dx ends up to be v times du dx, which is x squared times 0, minus u times dv dx, which is minus 1 times 2x. Now here's the tricky part on the bottom. The tricky part on the bottom is going to be you have to square. You get x squared to be squared. Okay? Now, once we're here, what we're going to get on top is minus 2x, okay? And what we got to remember is our rule of indices. When there's a bracket in between and there's no gap, you got to multiply the powers in this case, okay? So it's going to be x to the power of 4. Now, we have x1 divided by x4, okay? So if you get rid of 1x, and this one has 4x, so we get rid of x here, there's 3 of them left. So the answer could be minus 2 over x cubed. Or it could also be written as minus 2 over by x to the minus 3. Where x to the minus 3 basically means 1 over x cubed. Okay. Okay. The next question we're going to have in class is basically, we're going to be doing the third part here. Now, those of you who remember, right, when you differentiate x to the power of 4, the answer is 4x3. Okay? The only difference between this question and x to the power of 4 is actually that we have a half in front of it, okay? Which means that we got to multiply the 4 by a half. So we'll just see how this goes now, okay? So what we're going to do is we're going to rewrite this question so it looks something like this. And we're just going to treat it as we would normally, okay? So minus a half x to the power of 2. Now, remember, when we get to y dx, the only thing we ever redo in this scenario is we get the power and bring it to the front, okay? So we're going to multiply the power by the front, so it's going to be 4 times a half, 4 multiplied by a half, and then we're going to take 1 away from the power, which gives us x3. Then it's going to be a half multiplied by 2, x to the power 1. And what's going to happen here is 4 times a half is going to be 2, so we're going to get 2x cubed minus x to the power 1. And that's all there is to that one. Okay, next one. We've got to remember our steps for first principles. Okay, so the steps for first principles are as follows. Okay, there's no learning off here except from the steps. So you have to write down, first of all, what is f of x? What is f of x plus h? What is f of x plus h minus f of x? Okay, then we're going to get f of x plus h minus f of x all over h. And then finally, we had to replace all the h's with zeros and find the limit of f of x plus h minus f of x all over h. Okay, these are usually pretty long, but usually very simple as well. So the first step is f of x, okay? And f of x is x squared minus 4x. The next step is f of x plus h. This means replace all x's with x plus h's. I used to have x squared, now I'm going to have x plus h squared. Next step I'm going to have after that is minus 4 times x plus h. Now just a quick note about x plus h squared. X plus h squared actually means x plus h by x plus h. Okay? Then we multiply these out. Okay? And what we're going to get here is x squared plus hx plus hx plus h squared, which in turn is going to get us x squared plus 2hx plus h squared. So I'm just going to store this result in the corner here. So I can just input the answer up here, okay? So what we're going to get here is the following. We're going to get x squared plus 2hx plus h squared minus, now we forgot to multiply 4x by 4h, which is minus 4x minus 4h. Now, the next step here is we got to add in the first step, step 2, if you will, minus step 1. Okay? So step 2 is x squared plus 2hx plus h squared minus 4x minus 4h. And then we're going to have minus, now please remember the bracket, this is where the mistakes come in. We're taking away f of x, so minus x squared minus 4x. Now, minus x squared minus 4x actually turns out to be the minus 1 in here multiplies by the x squared to give you minus x squared, but also multiplies by the minus 4x to give you plus 4x. Then you're going to come in with a different colored pen. The minus 4x cancels with the plus 4x. The x squared cancels with the minus x squared. And if you've done this properly, okay, every term in this should have a h in it. So when you do this properly, you end up with 2hx plus h squared minus 4h. Our next step here is to write this out and divide everything in here by h. Okay? Now, you'll notice that there's a h in every one. The middle one, in fact, has two h's. H squared is hh. Okay, so divide 2hx by h, and the h in the middle disappears. Divide h squared by h, and what happens is one of the h's will disappear. So we'll just get rid of the 2 here, okay? So the 2 disappears off, and minus 4h divided by h is just minus 4. Now, at this stage, we're going to have 2x plus h minus 4. Now, we've written the limit as h approaches 0, so as the limit as h approaches 0, h turns into 0, which leaves us 2x minus 4. This is the answer we're expecting, as when you differentiate x squared minus 4x, you do in fact get 2x minus 4. So to wrap this lesson up in its completion, what we just had to do here is just say the first derivative is 2x minus 4. It really is that simple. Okay, next question, okay? Find the coordinates of the point of the curve. Find the coordinates. Now, first keyword you're looking at there is coordinates. Coordinates mean find the x and y points, okay? So the x and y points of the curve y equals 2x squared minus 6x plus 1, where the slope of the tangent of the curve is 2. Now, remember in differentiation, slope of the tangent of the curve means dy dx equals 2. Okay? And because dy dx equals 2, we have to find out what values of x make this happen. So the first thing we're going to do is we're going to differentiate dy dx, and we should get 4x minus 6. Okay, so 4x minus 6. Then we know that this equals 2. We're going to bring over the 6. 4x equals 8. Then we're going to divide by 4, and this will get us the answer is x equals 2. Now, we want coordinates, which means we want the x and the y value. We only got the x value. So to find out the y value is at x equals 2, we replace all x in this equation with 2. So 2 times 2 squared minus 6 times 2 plus 1. And what we get here is 8 minus 12 plus 1, which is minus 3. So the point at which this curve is, the tangent curve is 2, would be the point 2 minus 3. Now, what also wants us to do is to find the coordinates of the turning point of the curve and state if it's a maximum or a minimum. Okay. Now, because this is a x squared one, okay, so this is because this is an x squared, it only has one turning point, okay? So what we got to do once again, okay, is because it's x squared, only has one point. So to test our turning points, to get the turning points, we do dy dx equals 0, and then we solve x. And then to test if it's a max or a min, we do the second derivative test. And if it's less than 0, it's a max. And if it's greater than 0, it's a min. So let's find out what happens here, okay? So we're going to differentiate this, and once we've already differentiated this, and we got 4x minus 6. Now 4x minus 6 is equal to 0. 4x equals 6, because we moved the 6 over. Now we can divide by 4, so So what we're going to do here is we're going to say x, this means 4x equals 6, then just divide both sides by 4, x is equal to 6 over 4, x is going to be 1.5, okay? Now, we haven't got the point, we only have the x value, right? So in order to find out what the y value is, we need to insert this into the equation, okay? So we're going to find out what the y value is. So y is equal to, remember what it is, it's 2x squared minus 6x plus 1. So it's going to be 2 times 1.5 squared minus 6 times 1.5. And then on top, it's going to be plus 1. Okay? And we just put that into the calculator, and what do we get? 2 times 1.5 minus 6 times 1.5 plus 1. And the answer is minus 7 over 2. Okay, so y is minus 3.5 or minus 7 over 2. So 7 over 2, which is the same as minus 3.5. So this turning point is located at 1.5. Minus 3.5. Now, the unfortunate thing about having an equation that that has x squared in it is that there's no other turning points to compare it to. And because there's no other turning points to compare it to, we actually have to do the second derivative. So if we differentiate this a second time, so what we're doing is we're differentiating the 4x minus 6, differentiate a second time, and this is what's known as the second derivative. And the second derivative is going to be 4. And because 4 is bigger than 0, it's a minimum turning point. Okay? So the answer is, it's a minimum turning point. Okay. And...